This is the demineralized water that we're adding to the system right now. We're still trying to lower that pH. Okay, so I wanted to do another update for you guys. As you can see, we added a second grow lamp, and it's working great. I'm really, really happy with this. It's nice to get some more grow space, but I don't know if you can tell, but there is a 6500K bulb in here, so we have three of those, and then a 3000K bulb in here, so we have a blue spectrum and a red spectrum, and it's delivering, you know, both on an 18-hour cycle, and yeah, so let's go ahead and see what we have underneath. Okay, yeah, you can really see the difference between the blue and the red bulbs in there. And we went with 3000 because I couldn't actually find a 2700K bulb in a T8, and that's all we're running right now is T8, so we had to go with 3000. And they had a box of them at Home Depot, so that's what we did. So these are the plants. Let's go ahead and let these just adjust real quick. These are tomato plants, and we have 11 tomato plants. They're all indeterminate plants, and so I was kind of, I'm still a little weary about putting indeterminate tomato plants in my aquaponic systems because I don't know how well they're going to grow using this pull, or not this pulley, but this system. I mean, I can go pretty high, but I don't know if these T8s are going to be a sufficient amount of light to really grow my tomato plants. But that's why I'm here. I'm here to learn. So tomatoes, this is actually a green bean in one of our soil pods that I made up. I actually have a bunch of them over there. You can see there's some. These pods you buy at the, you know, Walmart, these are horrible. I hate these pods. I'll never use these again. Just because, see all the roots coming out of these plants? That's ridiculous. Here, I mean, we do get some root growth coming out, but that's only because they were sitting in these trays, I think. And once I actually took them out, you can see the roots kind of fading out. You know, you can see it on this one over there especially. But I think that's because of the air contact the roots are getting. But I'm not gonna use these anymore. These are bad, these are good. Bad, good. Anyway, and these are the pepper plants, bell pepper plants we have in here. And let's see, six bell pepper plants? Yeah, six bell, and they're growing pretty well. Not too bad. But I'm gonna be doing a video on these soil pods soon. I don't know when, but they're actually pretty neat. And I'm gonna start all my seedlings like this from now on. I can just take these and stick them directly into the ground. No root shock or anything like that, supposedly. So I wanted to show you that and give you guys an update. Everything else is pretty much the same. Moved in some stuff. It's my equipment, it's a CD player, things like that. But I'm not going to be uploading any more 1080p videos just because they take forever to upload. So I'm going to go ahead and just stick with 720p. Now, I'm sure you guys really don't care, but anyway, that's the update. And if you guys have any questions, please, I love fielding some questions, and that's what we're all here for, right? To learn. So. Anyway, you guys stay tuned, and I will update you again when there's something to update. Thanks for watching.